We're also given time to cut to Charles Keefe himself, along with his family, in order to emphasize the stakes. The call is once again being placed and things go according to plan.
Just tell them I authorized it.
Okay, oh my god, the cigars, the crystal.
There's hardly time, Lise. I better go.
When she tells him to keep his end of the deal, he reiterates, stating that he not only plans on killing Charles Keefe, but his entire family.
What?
His family's with him? You're gonna kill his family too?
I do my part, move on.
At the hotel, we see Keefe and his family have arrived and are informed of the room switch.
Who made the approval?
Lisa Reiser.
It's okay. I know her.
We need to sweep the room.
As the plane comes to a landing, Lisa begins to feel the resolve necessary to put a stop to Jackson's plan. Using the pen she stole from the guy earlier, she then starts by telling him the story of how she got her scar.
It happened in a parking lot.
The scar?
2 years ago. In the middle of the day, he held a knife to my throat. The whole time.
Let's put a smile on that face.
Ever since, I've been trying to convince myself of one thing over and over.
That it was beyond your control.
No. That it would never happen again.
And when the opportunity comes around, she seizes it.
K.O.!
Well, to be fair, at least she didn't go for the eyeball. And so the chase is on as she ducks past security while also throwing away her dainty old coat. Because damn it, she's independent now. She don't need it no more.
Not dangerous, really. No.
Jackson is fueled with revenge. And the little girl's presence in the story finally pays off. The chase goes on all across the airport. A yacht in the middle of the ocean, lifting up the crate from the beginning of the movie, which turns out to be a bazooka. Lisa then hijacks a minivan and hits the road.
Watch where you're going, you fool!
Warns her sister to warn everyone at the hotel that Keefe is a target for assassination, and has the place evacuated as the guys in the yacht launch a missile at the hotel.
Come on, we gotta hurry.
Another interesting fact. Did you know that these guys in the yacht were actually supposed to be American, but then were changed at the last minute to become Russian? As Lisa reaches the neighborhood, she's then spotted by the hitman and rams him over. She calls the hotel again to see what's up.
We've got to get out of here.
We've got to get out of here.
I just said that.
You just said that.
But wait, we still have 20 minutes left in the movie, so we have Jackson return and have his revenge. And shows he not strike her out. And here's how the rest of the movie plays out.
And now it's time for Rats Tales of Suspense!
Ha 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 ha! taunts him on his failure as an assassin, she heads off. She then trips him up with a chair, runs her way up the stairs. As he runs up, she kicks him in the pants and headbutts him back. He then sinisterly pulls her pump right out of his pants and locks the door. He grabs a knife from his now dead partner and limps his way back up the stairs. She sneaks her way out the window and on the ledge down the fire escape. He makes it up the stairs only to find that she's gone. She then sneaks her way through the back of the house and soon follows after, dragging Colonel Stryker away. Pass the ketchup. He then makes to the kitchen and finds them both missing. She then throws a vase and another chair at him. And then locks him inside the room upstairs. And gives this retort.
Where's your male-driven, fact-based logic now, Jack? I don't think that's what got you here.
Meanwhile, we see downstairs that Stryker gets back up. She then runs over to the other room to try to hide, while he breaks out of the room and scopes the scene, while she defends herself with a baseball bat. She checks the shower to see that he's not there. He is behind the door. She strikes him out and tucks the blade away, and they wrestle control over each other, and he pins her to the wall, then throws her down the stairs, because he just really wanted to play some live slinky. But as he comes down, she grabs the dead hitman's nearby gun and lets him have it. So we wrap things up with the police on their way as they investigate the hotel. Keith gives his final blessings.
We have to go. Let's talk soon, yes?
She gets back at those annoying yuppie customers from earlier.
Do you have any idea what we have been through? You can go ahead and just shove it up your ass.
But then things just go back to normal as though nothing happened at all.
Jackson's eyes ever actually turn red anywhere throughout the entire movie? I feel gypped.
Yeah, this certainly isn't one of Craven's best films, but it does certainly show his craft as the master of horror and suspense. Unlike another certain film of his that came out the exact same year, though it is quite sad to see some of his master work being overshadowed by nothing but shitty remake after shitty remake, made simply to be consumed by the mindless, vapid youth culture of today. Although apparently this film does have quite the following of fangirls, always gushing on about how Lisa and Jackson should have been an item, completely ignoring the fact that it's not that kind of fucking movie.
But Halloween season ain't over yet, as we still got another spooktacular review next time. Don't die!
Sally or Ruthie. In fact, if you're a girl and have a name, any name, please come to the information booth. The young man would like to meet you.
So, does this mean death by exile?